your pardon. And Kimi has to be there because that's the priority technique. That's really the technique. If a technique doesn't have Kimi, you can't score with it. Now let's look at this for a second, okay? Now, if I did that to his face, and I went back to his face, I'd have a game. If I stop the technique, they say it doesn't have any power. And if I go like this, they say I missed. Is that right? So that technique doesn't have Hickey, does it? So the rules say that you have to have a technique with Hickey. So that's what you have to create. So the spin kicks in that. It's not that they're not effective. It's not that they can't hurt the person. But they don't fit the definition of what, in USAKR, the rule code, is a point. Okay, you understand? No, you don't understand. Because you heard me say, what? A pawn. I used the word point again, nobody cut it, did you? It's a pawn. So in a pawn, you have to have that avenue team. So, you know, you throw something like this, it can't support it, you do that. But some techniques, you either hit the guy with it, you don't. You know? They don't have the ability to be controlled at the target area without losing too much of the criteria for a pawn. So that's why those techniques don't score. They don't score because of the way the rules are designed. Does not mean they're not effective. Okay, now, there's a couple other things you have to do in order to get your pawn or your bazaar. Now, let's think about this. We know what they are now, right? Okay, everybody here knows what we have to do for a pawn and what we have to do for a bazaar. Okay, now, to get a pawn or bazaar, there's a few simple things that have to happen. What are they? First thing has to be what? A karate technique. Now, think competitions, okay? And don't just limit your thinking to karate competitions. Think of any type of karate competition, any type of sport competition. What's the second thing? The karate technique has to be done when? Not at the right time, what? That's close. Has to be done while the match is in play. Right? You can't score when the referee says you're on it, can you? So it has to be a karate technique while the match is in play. And what else? Very simple things. To what? To a target. To a target. And one other little thing has to happen. Inbounds. You have to be inbounds. Okay? So a karate technique to a target area while the match is in play, while the fighter is inbound. Probably there's another way of saying it. Does that make sense? So now we know what karate technique, but we know what the karate technique has to have that we talked about this is right here. We know what it means when a match is in play. Okay, when a referee says Yame, the match what? Starts or stops? And when he says Hajime, it begins, right? Okay, now you're at the very end of the match. Okay? They call time over here. You get scored on, the referee goes Jame. That's the order of events. They say time, you get hit, the referee says Jame. Does that score count?
Yes.
No.
No.
The referee determines when match is in play all circumstances for the end of the match. The referee does not control the end of the match unless they change the current outcome of the rules. Right now, for the last 10 years, it hasn't been since 1983, it hasn't been that way. And the scorekeeper says time. Scoring possibilities are over. You can penalize. You can foul and give the person a score. Okay, you got that? But scoring opportunities end. The referee can say, yeah, hey, it makes no difference on the end of the scoring opportunity. So bear in mind that what we said was correct, but then we have one circumstance that was not correct. And that's the end of the match. The tie up. No. Okay? Sets the end of the scoring possibilities. What can we say? We know about targets. What are the targets, you guys? If you're going to go to the targets, what are they? What are the targets? What are the targets? You're, here you are scoring the pawn, right? hold on here. This guy's actually got his hands up. I want to ask that. What's his argument? All right. What?
What's the bat?
Great. So it's a kick to the bat that doesn't score. Out of bounds, you try to hit it and you miss, you're both out of bounds. That's what So if you can skillfully put somebody in and force them out of bounds and score at the same time, you get more than what you normally get, don't you? On the other side of the coin, if you miss a run of bounds, you both get to go back. So it's kind of like, you got to gamble there. Play it right, come out way ahead. So again, that comes into your strategy and tactics. Okay, so there we go. Try to technique, match play target in bounds. Now I want to talk about one more thing here, and then we're going to take a break and come back, and we're going to see what we can do about figuring out how to get these things. Okay? Now, Wuko and his wisdom decided that karate matches were too boring. Because all they were punches. Huh? The guy was standing there and he knew the stick of reverse punches. The guy had sword and shield fighting. You remember Spanish talk about sword and shield fighting? And that's all it was. So you go and grab the warrior, just standing in a ring, going bang, clomp, bang, clomp. And nobody wants to watch that. And that's one of the problems getting the Olympics. Okay? You gotta make sure it's sports interesting. So what they did was they looked at what was a pun, and they looked at what maybe the referees weren't really calm, that they, you know, give a con, but then they didn't want to go side on the referees and tell them what they were doing. So they came up with what they call technical exceptions. And those are techniques where they're going to give you the con, even if it's not in the con. So if you do a Wazari technique, you're going to give it a con for it. You understand? And if your technique is not a Wazari, what do you get? Nothing. You got that? So these are techniques that can only earn a pun. They got to be at least Wazari quality to be in a pun. If they're less than Wazari, it's nothing. Okay, anybody know what they are?
Face.
Yeah, kick from the bonus and they kick to the face and say hi to the high kicks. Okay, Jodan. Very. Kicks to the head. So that happens. Right? So if you come up and you get a nice round, let's kick to the head, they're going to climb that. So you understand what that does, we'll get back to you guys in a second. That created a more exciting technique to hit. And they tried to give the fighters a reason to do it by giving it a bigger reward than what it would normally get. Because a lot of the Japanese officials don't think you can have Zan Shin to kick the guy in the head. And some of you guys are really good with kicking, so darn well you can have real good Zan Shin, but they don't see it that way. And when you try to get 130 different countries together and have one mind, I mean, we can't even do that the way we do ourselves. We're going to try to do that karate competition where everybody thinks they know what they're doing. You know? Okay. So, good on Gary. Now, somebody else give me another one.
Oh,
well, what kind of walking pattern? Well, what do you have with walking pattern? You're close. What?
Sin.
What's sin or sin?
Sin. The opponent punches first when you score.
That's not what he was saying. So what's the exception you're talking about?
Block, spin around.
Okay, a block. And attack. What? To the unguarded back of the opponent. Okay. Alright. So everybody got hold of the piece. So what that means is if you're standing there like this and he kicks you, you block the stretch of the belly, that's not his opponent. Okay. But if he can kick, you can turn him to his back and you can come on, they're going to give that a higher level reward. Now, and that you might say is a form of gono sen. That's a form of gono sen. Now, what is seno sen? Who has seno sen? Who said that? What is it?
It's when the opponent punches first.
Attacking it did. No, not too well. Not quite. What?
Attacking the initial attack.
Attacking the precise moment the opponent attacks. Precise moment, that's the way it's worded in the Wuko rules, and that's 7-7. Precise moment the opponent attacks, they attack, and bingo, they get there first. They bring that up. It doesn't have to be a one. Okay, so I'm just going to write 7-7. And I'm going to put precise moment. Alright, so we got 1, 2, 3. How many are there?
6.
I don't know, I can't count that out. How many are
there?
5. There are 5 exceptions, not 6. Okay, now, what is the next class?
Do you have a seat?
Pardon? Yes. You got a blocking attack and then very back to the opponent. Okay, a sweep, right? And a punch. Now, okay, if going to what? Have the capacity to kill the opponent, right? So these circumstances hopefully take you to their conclusion would permit you a killing blow. It's not one killing blow, but a circumstance to give rise to a killing blow. Okay, so that has to be like this now, okay? It's my opinion. So if I happen to come up to him, and I go, I need him boom, he gives me boom, and I need him back boom, I got two bizarre. Right? What is that? How? He hit me back in between. Did I show dominance over him?
He didn't keep his eyes open.
Well, keep his eyes open. I'm trying to keep to the example. The example is this, change body. Okay. I hit him, and he can hit me. He's already broken a combination. If it was a good combination, I hit him boom, and I hit him again. He'd have no ability to hit me back. I gotta show dominance. There's no dominance if he can punch me back, right? Okay. Now I'll give you a good one. What's I use? Good. Now, what is meant by simultaneous technique? That's all nice of you to say the right words. Now, what do you mean by that? Huh? Right? You score at the same time. That's interesting. You know what the initial, the old one was? I'll show you. He comes up here, and he hits me. But I want you to put your back here real fast. That's a huge. That's the old language. Because if he had a good karate technique, they didn't consider karate technique if I could punch him back. That's not karate. It's the old concept now. I'm going back into it. The old concept was, if I hit him boom and he can hit me immediately back, no, why score that? It's a stupid thing to score. Because if he punches, now you can score because I stopped him from scoring me back. That's the old concept of Ayush. Simultaneous scoring. If I cut his head off, oh, he's cutting my jugular vein, and I have to cut his head off first, I'm still going to die. Right? If you're in a sword fight, right? Either he's going to kill me, I'm going to kill him, we're going to kill each other. So you only have one out of three chances of walking away alive. You see? Now think of it that way, and I usually make sense. But today it's not that. Today it is who hit first. Okay? We score who hit first. So if I score on him and he hits me split second later, we go with that. And I usually supposed to be simultaneous. Now that definition is almost impossible that it's not simultaneous. So I usually should be very rare under the current rule structure. Too often I read by usually